Children, let's start with chapter number 25, pie chart. Definition: a graph that display data in a circular graph is called a pie chart or a pie graph. This is a circle which represent angle of 360 degree, because it looks like a whole angle or a complete angle. The chart is divided into sectors. Now these are called the sectors, like these angles are called the sectors, where each sector shows the size of the value. Each sector shows the size of the value. Now for example, this pie graph shows money spent, and money spent is in rupees on various items. We'll check one example so that we get to know how do we draw the pie graph. Suppose we have soap brand A, B, C and D, and the sale of a particular month 1000 rupees, 500 rupees, 1500 rupees and 600 rupees. Keep in your mind that whenever you draw a pie graph, the value of the given product or the given item must be in degrees. We cannot draw a pie graph with rupees or percentage or any other value, because it represents a central angle, that's a whole angle, so it must be in degrees. Now how do we convert? First value is 1000. Now 3600 is the total of the sales multiplied by 360 degrees, and we'll get 100 degrees, that is the central angle. 500, 5 upon 3600 multiplied by 360, it is 50 degrees. 1500, 1500 upon 3600 into 360 degrees, that is 150 degrees. 600 upon 3600 into 360 degrees, which is 60 degrees. And after we find all the values of the central angle, do check the total, because the total has to be 360 degrees. Now we'll start with exercise 25, starting with question number 1. Let's read the question first. Represent the budget of a family as a circle graph. Now circle graph is another name for a pie graph or a pie chart. Now these are items: rent, food, clothing, education, savings and miscellaneous. All the small expenses come under miscellaneous, and the expenditure is given in percentage form. Find the amount spent on education if the income of the family is 1000 rupees. Now this is the second part of the question. We'll first start with a circle graph or a pie graph. We'll make a table. Solution number 1. Now these are items: rent, food, clothing, education, savings and miscellaneous. Amount spent, but it is given in percentage: 20%, 40%, 15%, 12%, 8% and 5%, and the total of the percentage is here 100%. Now how do we convert to find the central angle? Starting with first 20%, so 20 upon the total of the percentage multiplied by 360 degrees, because we have to convert it into degrees, so we get 72 degrees. Next, 40 upon 100 into 360 degrees, which comes as 144 degrees. 15 upon 100 into 360 degrees, that's 54 degrees. 12 upon 100 into 360 degrees, which is 43.2 degrees. 8 upon 100 into 360 degrees, that is 28.8 degrees. 5% is 5 upon 100 into 360 degrees, which is 18 degrees. And the total is 360 degrees. Now comes the second part of the question, where we have to draw the pie graph. This was only the conversion table, and after the conversion table only we draw the pie graph. Now how do we draw the pie graph? Let's see. First, draw a circle, but do draw the circle using a compass, because we need this center point. So we'll draw a circle with any radius, we'll draw the circle, and then we'll draw one line here. That's the base for the first angle. What is the first angle? 72 degrees. So we'll now take the protractor. That's how we keep the protractor. Keep on the center point. And where you get 72 degrees, just make a mark. This is 72 degree point. You can see. And then pick up your protractor and join this center point to the point marked. But when we draw the line, we will draw the line only up till the boundary of the circle. This is first 72 degrees, rent. Now next is 144 degrees. We have already used this line as the base. So now what we are going to do, we'll rotate the copy like this. For the second angle, which is food, 144 degrees, the next line will be taken as the base. Now keep your protractor like this again. And 144 degrees. Wherever you get 144 degrees, make a mark, pick up the protractor and again join it extend the line only up to the boundary. Next, now this line is also taken. Again, rotate your copy. So for the next angle, this line will be taken as the base. The next angle is clothings, that is 54 degrees. So let's keep the protector, and where you get 54 degrees, make a mark. Pick up your protector, join this line and extend it only up till the boundary. Same ways we'll draw the other parts also, that is education 43.2 degrees, savings 28.8 degrees, and the last one, which is miscellaneous 18 degrees, we don't draw because towards the end whatever is left is the last value. But keep in mind that for every angle your base will remain changing, like it will keep changing, like for the first, for the second, then for the third, for the fourth, fifth, and so on till you finish off with the values. Now, as per the question, there was one question. You have to find amount spent on education. The total income was 1000 rupees. Education, we are spending 12% on education. So, amount spent on education is 12% of rupees 1000. 12% means 12 upon 100 multiplied by 1000. On reducing, the money spent on education is 120 rupees. Now, question number 2. Mr. Mohan's monthly income is 720 rupees. If a pie chart is drawn to show how he spends his income under various heads, for example, rent, food, clothing, etc., find the money spent on rent if it is represented by a sector of 75 degrees, which means that the money that we are spending on rent is actually 75 degrees in the pie graph. And you have to only keep two things in mind, the monthly income as well as the degree measure of the money spent on rent. Let's start. Solution number 2, monthly income is rupees 720, that's 720. Money spent on rent is 75 degrees of the total income, that is rupees 720. 75 degrees, 75 upon, now it is degree, so the total of the degree, we all know it's a complete angle, which is of 360 degrees, upon 360 degrees multiplied by 720 rupees. On reducing, we will get 150. So therefore, the money spent on rent is rupees 150. Okay, question 3. The table shows market position of the various brands of soap. Draw a pie chart to represent the following information. The brands are A, B, C, and D. Others, then the percentage of buyers 60, 20, 15, and these are the percentages. Now let's see. The first thing is we'll make a table, brands A, B, C, and others. Then percentage buyers 60, 20, 15, and 5. Now before we put up the values in the pie graph, we have to convert them. First one is 60. Now this is actually 60%, and the total of the percentage is 100%, and multiplied by 360 degrees, because to find the central angle, it must be converted into degrees. It's 216 degrees. Next, 20 upon 100 into 360, that's 72 degrees. 15 upon 100 into 360 degrees, that's 54 degrees. 5 upon 100 into 360 degrees, which is 18 degrees. And the total of the degrees is 360 degrees. Now, when we start drawing the pie graph, you will notice that the first value, it's a reflex angle. And it's slightly difficult to put up the reflex angle. But let's see, if we want to put the reflex angle as the measure, 180 degrees plus what gives you 216. So from 206 directly subtract 180 degrees, that is 336 degrees. So this is the starting line, this is the starting line, and we all know that it's a 180 degree is a straight line. And after this, we will draw this angle from here to here of 36 degrees. Then brand B, 72 degrees. Brand C, 54 degrees. And for the fourth one, others, that is 18 degrees, automatically you will get.